Hi everyone and welcome back to Sonselva. I'm excited to show you a very special project today. The planting of our very own Miyawaki Forest. And doing it in a way that truly closes the loop by returning nutrients from our own waste back to the land. The foundation of any forest is healthy living soil, and for us this starts with our composting toilet. Here we've been safely turning our own poop into rich fertilizer that we can use for our new forest. It might sound strange to others, but our own poop is actually a really good source for nutrients for plants. It's actually not much different than using horse manure in the garden. But of course there are some things you need to consider. First of all, we're not going to use the compost that we produce from our own poop in our vegetable garden or our food forest. That's why I've been waiting to plant the Miyawaki forest, which will be completely native and in another area than our fruit trees. The second important thing is that the compost needs to be fully decomposed, especially to avoid E. coli bacteria that are harmful if we ever gonna end up eating out of that soil again. So whenever one of our buckets is full, I just close the lid and let it sit outside in the sun for a couple of months. That way we have an aerobic and an anaerobic composting cycle. And the third important thing is that you and your nutrition decides on the quality of your humanure. So make sure you eat healthy. Don't consume any antibiotics or hormonal birth control, because this will all end up in our soil. So I've been patiently collecting buckets and buckets of poop, and now we finally have a place for them to grow a new forest. Let me show you. So in the back of our toilet, we have our storage from all the poop buckets. This is how a bucket looks after about a month. Since it varies a lot, like how much poop comes into our buckets, depending on workshops or if I'm here by myself, I don't really know how long I should let it sit, but I think the easiest way is just to look at it, smell it, and once it smells good, they get emptied out in our new Miyawaki forest area. During the whole composting process, we're also adding something to help decompose a bit more quickly, which is the EM, effective microorganisms. They also help with the smell and just speed up the whole process. And we cover up our remains with a scoop full of sawdust, pine needles, and seagrass. Now let me walk you over to the new forest area. When we first built this composting toilet, a lot of people asked why I chose this specific location, because it's quite far away from our base camp or wherever we usually eat. And now it finally makes sense, because of course I have planned this all along. And with our new Miyawaki forest, we finally closed the loop between the toilet and this area. If you're new to the concept, the Miyawaki method is a reforestation technique developed by the Japanese botanist Akira Miyawaki. The idea is simple but powerful. Plant dense clusters of native trees and shrubs, mimic the layers of a natural forest, and let nature do the rest. The big advantage of the Miyawaki system is that you actually don't need a lot of space. So technically, you could plant your own forest in your backyard or in the middle of your city somewhere or on a terrace. For this Miyawaki forest, I started with about 20 square meters only. And on this 20 square meters, we've planted over 50 young native trees and shrubs and herbs very, very densely. This feels a bit counterproductive because usually we space out trees to all have their own space to grow. But what Miyawaki found out with his studies is that it can work quite the opposite way around. If we observe and look how a forest grows all by itself, that's actually exactly how nature does it. If you imagine a grown oak tree, the mama tree actually drops all her oaks right where she is. So on one square meter of a native forest, you can find a lot of baby trees shooting up. They're protected by their mother. They have great soil from the leaves that are decomposing below her trunk. And because they are so close to each other, they actually grow much quicker because they have to compete for light and space. So we're taking this observation and simulating it in this area by planting very, very closely, but also by providing them the best soil quality we can. Baby. Yeah, good girl! Good girl!
Of course you can plant a Miyawaki forest without using human poop. You can use regular compost or animal manure instead. Let me show you how to start your own Miyawaki forest. We started this project back in April by inviting the pigs into this area to help prepare and till the soil.
Today I'm preparing a new plot of land that I haven't been working on ever, actually, since I bought this land. As you can tell in the back, the only thing we've made here was that we had a tractor who cleared this kind of path where I'm standing right now. But besides that, nothing has been done here for over 15 years, I would say. So to prepare this plot for planting, I'm gonna throw out some food for the pigs to encourage them to dig here.
That's why our mini forest has this weird shape now. That's just the area they chose to dig in. After the pigs did their work, we spread a rich layer of manure compost across the planting area. We want our soil to be as close to a forest soil as possible. Next came a layer of forest soil from our healthy local woodland, full of microorganisms and fungal networks to kickstart life. Then we started planting with the help of our workshop participants. It was a real community effort and it turned into a joyful planting party. We've chosen only native species for this forest. All Mallorcan trees, herbs and shrubs that are adapted to the Mediterranean climate. Layering pioneer species with low growers, understory shrubs with taller trees. We planted up to 3 trees per square meter. If done correctly, a Miyawaki forest should be growing 3 times as quickly as if you use regular reforestation methods. Then we topped it all off with a thick layer of wood chips from our own trees. This mulch will protect the soil, retaining moisture and feed the ecosystem as it breaks down. This way, we are creating a resilient ecosystem and doing it in a way that heals the land instead of harming it. And finally, we connected a grey water tube from the sink to our forest to use every single drop twice. We're regenerating soil, harvesting our own nutrients, mimicking natural systems, and doing it all with what we already have. What started as a dry, compacted land is now home to over 100 young plants, and hopefully In a couple of years, this will be a dense, vibrant forest, buzzing with life. From our pocket forest of 20 square meters, we can then take cuttings and seeds to extend the area with every poop bucket we provide.
To me, this is so much more than just about planting trees. It's about restoring the ecosystem and helping nature to recover. Even though these plants should be really resilient because they're all from the island and used to these hot summers, they do need some water in the beginning. So I am counting on all our visitors to frequently wash their hands after using the toilet because that's all the water they're getting at the moment. I will keep you updated on how this forest grows and hope this video inspires you to rethink waste, plant native, and maybe start your own little forest one day. Thank you so much for watching and see you in the next video.